As the public awaited news on the Boston Marathon bombings, many families in Texas were devastated by a deadly fertilizer plant explosion. In tonight's Teditorial, Teddy Locsin Jr. takes us back to the town of West and shares his thoughts on the blast.
The day after the horrifying Boston Marathon bombing that killed three so far, wounded 170, most in critical condition, slashing off at the thigh the legs of runners, blowing away an 8-year-old boy who once scrawled a message that all the world's hurting must end, and maiming his little sister. Indeed, the day after what many suspected without any proof yet was typical Islamo-fascist carnage, what was clearly a dastardly deed of capitalist fascist mass destruction was perpetrated, leveling the town of West in Texas, killing at least five, injuring almost 200, and leveling close to 70, including old folks' homes. It was far from being the only one of its kind. It was definitely not an unanticipated accident, because in 1947, in what is billed as the worst industrial accident in the U.S. history, a ship carrying 2,300 tons of ammonium nitrate caught fire and detonated, killing more than 600 and wiping Texas City off the map of Texas. Unlike the World Trade Center bombing and its subsequent total destruction, and unlike the Boston Marathon, no one will be brought to justice in this case of clear criminal negligence amounting to homicidal intent, because highly volatile fertilizer factories never catch fire to blow up, which is what happened in West Texas last week and in Texas City in 1947. Of the perpetrators of the World Trade Center destruction, a U.S. president said, "You can run, but you cannot hide." Of the owners and managers of fertilizer factories that detonated like weapons of mass destruction, U.S. senators might say at worst, "We will call on you when we are up for re-election." Yes, murdering capitalists do not have to run and do not have to hide, as long as they cough up. Keep well.